Imagine this, a figure larger than life, captivating millions with his presence and voice. A man who, even after his death, continues to inspire a devotion so intense that it has sparked a movement, a potential new religion. No, we're not talking about any ancient prophet or biblical figure. We're talking about Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll. Yes, you heard that right. Elvis, the guy who shook up the music world, might just be the center of a faith that's taking the world by storm. It's a mind-boggling idea, isn't it? But when you delve deeper into the world of Elvis fans, you'll find a community that sees him as more than just a musical icon. They believe Elvis has a divine, almost Jesus-like quality. Crazy, right? Yet, this idea has gained traction, with experts and psychologists taking notice. Dr. Richard Maddock, a psychologist who studied consumer behavior and even done research at Graceland, Elvis's iconic home, has some intriguing insights. He believes Elvis's impact goes beyond his music and performances. Elvis allowed people to accept their impulses, Dr. Maddock explains. He gave them permission to feel free from guilt, just like Jesus did. You see, Elvis's entire career seemed to be about liberating people from their guilt. In the 1950s, when he first appeared on television, he did things that were considered taboo. He broke free from the traditional norms and showed people that it was okay to be themselves, even if it meant going against societal expectations. It was like he was saying, "Your feelings are valid, and you don't have to feel bad about them." As his career progressed, Elvis added another layer to his act. During his concerts, he not only performed his signature moves, but also included spiritual songs. It was as if he was telling his fans, not only are your impulses acceptable, but they are blessed too. Now, this is where things get really interesting. In Christianity, Jesus, as the Son of God, has the authority to forgive sins. It's a powerful concept. But some Elvis fans have started to grant Elvis a similar status, almost as if he were a modern-day savior. They believe he has an otherworldly connection, both during his life and even after his death. Think about it, Elvis's music and presence seemed to offer a form of salvation to his fans. It gave them a way to escape their guilt and find acceptance. Just like Jesus, Elvis became a figure of hope and redemption for many. You might be thinking, okay, but is it really that serious? Well, prepare to be amazed, because the similarities don't stop there. The structure of Elvis tribute concerts has some striking parallels with the Christian Mass. During a Christian Mass, worshipers receive the body and blood of Christ symbolically through bread and wine. It's a powerful ritual initiated by Jesus himself during the Last Supper. Similarly, at an Elvis concert, audience members receive scarves and a kiss from the performer. It's a tradition that Elvis started, and even though he didn't leave specific instructions for it to continue, it has become a beautiful remembrance of the king. Patty Carroll, a photographer who met over 100 Elvis tribute artists, puts it perfectly. She says the scarf is a souvenir, but the kiss is the true communion. It's a special moment, she explains. You have to feel worthy to receive the gift. But it's not just about the rituals, it's also about the people leading them. In the Christian church, priests are ordinary mortals, flawed like the rest of us. But when they put on their vestments and stand at the altar, they become representatives of Christ. It's a transformation, a sacred role. Similarly, Elvis tribute artists, or priests as some might call them, need more than just their singing voices to create the illusion. They need the right clothes, props, lighting, and music. It's a transformation, just like a priest's vestments. And here's where it gets even more fascinating. The Bible, in the book of Exodus, talks about how Aaron, the first Jewish priest, was given special garments for his role. "And thou shalt make holy garments for Aaron, thy brother, for glory and for beauty," it says. And guess what? Elvis's middle name was Aaron. Coincidence? Maybe not. The most intriguing parallel, however, lies in the theology behind both Elvis and Jesus. The Christian Mass celebrates Christ's suffering as a man, his death, and his triumphant resurrection. It's a belief that God became a man, lived among us, suffered and died, but ultimately conquered death. Now, listen to the lyrics of Elvis's Song in American Trilogy. It captures these three key points perfectly. Elvis sings about being born in Dixieland, implying a real human existence. He talks about suffering and offers words of comfort, almost predicting his death. But then he switches to the triumphant glory, glory hallelujah, echoing the victory over death. This interpretation has led some fans to draw parallels between Elvis and Jesus. Both were born into challenging circumstances, destined to suffer and die, but ultimately triumphing over death. It's a powerful connection that has left many fans pondering the deeper meaning behind Elvis's life and legacy. Even in art, Elvis has been depicted as a suffering figure akin to the Lamb of God in atoning sacrifice. One art exhibition featured the work of photographers Robert E. Lewis and Lawrence Jassid, who paired vivid images of Christ's passion with decorated pictures of Elvis laid on his grave or prepared in his memory. It's a visual representation of the deep connection some fans see between Elvis and religious figures. So, is Elvis Presley the center of a new religion? That's a question that might just keep scholars and fans debating for years to come. What we do know is that Elvis's impact on the world was and still is profound. He touched the lives of millions, offering them a sense of freedom, acceptance, and even salvation. Whether you see him as a musical legend or a potential messiah, one thing is certain. Elvis Presley's legacy continues to inspire and captivate generations, leaving an indelible mark on our world.